We now start up with the gearbox and all the rest of the functions. I will actually try to build it first and see how it works. And then later I will try to fit it into the model with all the rest of the functions. It's very important for LEGO Technic that we have these functions because this is a part of the Technic idea. So in this one, we have the suspension, front and back. It was also a little bit problem with the gearbox because it has to be flat, so we actually have the space for the engine. When you see the back, you can see the suspension, the red ones. There are actually four in this one. In the normal Lamborghini, it's only two. But the weight of the model is so high that we need to put in extra suspension. We also put in, we call it a window, underneath of the model, so you actually can see what happens when you are shifting the gears. This is also an important thing, so you actually can see what happens when you shift the gears.
Yeah, when I see for the first time this project, for me I say it's impossible. My difficulty was to understand in what way something that is a standard, let me say, I don't want to say standard, but there is a level of modularity so important like in the Lego can reply a car like a Sian. And when we had the first meeting and they start to see the result, I was shocked because at the end is a Sian. And what shocked me more is the level of accuracy that there are in the technical definition of the components. There are components that in my mind was, okay, only aesthetic. Okay, aesthetic, you can simulate it, you can build some specific and so. But when I discover the level of accuracy that there are in all the mechanical components of a car, like the gearbox, and the fact that the gearbox really work, if I move the lever inside, I have a synchronizer that go up and down, I say, oh my God, it's impossible. And I think my first question was, I will be able to assemble something like this? And my first answer was probably no. And if I think that I am able to imagine, to think, to engineering a car, and they see the level of accuracy that is here in the suspension, in the arm, in the gearbox, in the every system that is moving inside the car is really wow. But the same is on the rear differential. And when I perceive that there is exactly, let me say, the same effects when you have our car, when normally is on the lifter, and you go in the back and you move one wheel, and if you move in this direction, the other, due to the differential, go opposite. And they see here that happened the same. I say, oh my God, this is really taking account all the functionality of the car. It's not only, let me say, it's not only a toy. It's really a piece of engineering that is able to reply all what I put in a car, here they put in this marvelous model.